look at the camera and say, hi, I am the SAS angle and you're
I'm not saying that.
What do you think of the SAS angle?
A hazer. Hi, I'm Mark. Mark Scanlon with my blunt force trauma book.
I always walk around the gym caffeine, just like this. Okay, we're ready now.
Ballistic beats. Listen. Look. Ain't the best in line or next in line. Don't care about you or the rest in line. I'll jump the queue with the rest in line. Please share your views with the rest in line. Can't talk for the rest in line, but ain't trying to hear you're the best in line. Unlike the rest in line, I'll clash you and the rest in line. Don't need you or the rest in line, and I won't need you in the rest in grand. You and the rest in line can go fish with whoever's next in line. I ain't trying to queue up with the rest in line. I'll push past and spew up on the best in line. Jump the queue and the rest in line. One line flow yet again. Ain't got your money on me, but again. I got too many flows, guess again. And I got crepes that you can't get again. One line flow yet again. Ain't got your money on me, but again. I got too many flows, guess again. And I got crepes that you can't get again. I like sleep. Suffer with insomnia, so my body fights sleep. I write grief. I'm a product of my environment. They didn't make many like me. From a secluded area of music, which some may call the grime scene. If I end up on your pirate radio show, it's a crime scene. I make Miss Daisy drive me and she buys the ice creams. I'm 8 times 3, you do the math. 4 grams short of an OZ. You can Google the raps. And when I see the poodle and the tramp, they better have a Ruger in front.
Yeah, Kaobon is my coach Colin. He's originally a Thai boxing coach. So Kaobon means heron, which is Colin's second name, and it's in Thai. This is where everyone has to get past Colin or Kenny or one of the lads who's working on the desk. Basically, we've got a system where they come in and they'll swipe one of these. That's if they pay monthly. Just like Total Fitness, though, you just swipe it through and go in. Or you just pay individually for your sessions. So, anyone who goes in there has got to go past here. Go through. Right, this is the entrance. It's where the magic happens. Yeah, you've got Kyle. He's the boss man. He's always on the desk. If you come in without paying, he'll fuck you up. Won't you, lad? This is where all the training gets done. Got the cage over there, the ring, the big matter there with some bags, just your essential cardio bits. So. I'm going to take you through to the dormitory. All the changing rooms through there and a cupboard full of equipment. You alright then? Going to get you on camera now. This is our lovely Wendy. She's hiding in the corner over there. She looks after all the lads' beds, does the washing when lads come over to stay. She maintains the cleanliness of the gym. Make sure no one gets dirty staff or ringworm. Our lovely Wendy. This is just the dormitories. We get a lot of lads coming over from. Recently it's been all over Europe. A lot of Irish lads or even kids who come up from down south just to stay for a couple of weeks training. It's a bit cramped, but it's coming here to train, so you don't need a life of luxury really, do you? No big double beds. The kitchen. All the lads make the food. Just got all your basics, your foreman, microwave. You don't get no Jamie Olivers in here, but I don't think it's that hard to make a bit of chicken and rice. City of God. Belt of Fosville. At the bottom we've got a massage bed just for, we've got a physio who comes in, does a bit of treatment on the lads. There's a bed down there, it's not really much to see. I've been doing MMA for 6 years. First started about 5-6 years ago. I'd done a bit of submission wrestling. But before that, I'd done a lot of football and boxing, and I'd had knee surgery when I was about 16, 17. So for like 2-3 years, I had 3 operations. So basically just done weights and ate loads of KFC for 3 years. The third surgery I got loads of physio. I went private on the last one. The first two was on the NHS and it didn't work too good. So the last one I got it done properly. As soon as my knee got better, I went back to playing a bit of football, doing some boxing again. And one of my mates introduced me to a submission wrestling club called Atherton Submissions in about 25, 30 minutes away in Lee. So first time I went, I was about 16 and a half stone, full of Kentucky. I loved it. As soon as I'd done that, that was it. Stopped doing weights, even stopped playing football. Just started to concentrate more on doing more MMA boxing and submission wrestling. And obviously, because I'd watched a few UFCs, I was a big fan of UFC. Just all went from there, really. This is the matted area we've got. 4 circles on. We try and use them, obviously, because we can't fit five cages in here. The last thing you want to do when you're sparring is start running all over the gym, bumping into each other. And obviously, it's better if you can try and work to a circle or work to an area instead of getting chased around and not using. Like, you want to stay off the cage or keep your backs away from the fences. So we'll use the circles. When we're sparring each person, I'll try and take a circle each or each group. We'll use the ring, and then we've got the cage. Normally, the cage you get hogged by whoever's got a fight coming up. So, which is me. Recently, the last couple of weeks, I've been cage hogging. It's like a fight to get in the cage. Either me or Mark Adams. Even when he's got no fight, he's the cage whore. So, I think he's over. It's Brigadier's flag, Brazilian flag. But we get a lot of Brazilian lads as well coming over, Brigadier's friends, so just to make them feel a bit more at home. Throw a little bit of green, blue and yellow around. We've got the ring. That's mostly the Thai lads who fight, I'll use that. But just with there being so many lads in the gym, you've got to make as much space as you can, so. This is where the cage whores go. This is mine for the next 2 weeks until I go to Germany for my first UFC fight. So, to be murder. Anyone tries to come in here for the next 2 weeks and the sparring sessions, I'll be at the door waiting for them.
With Kaobon, like originally it was Next Generation Kaobon, and then like the two gyms split up. I just wanted to carry on with the grappling. So that's why I just went with Next Generation. And then I had all mates still at Kaobon. So when Next Generation split up, I came back to Kaobon. But being at UFC 120, the whole fight worked out to plan. It's what I train for. It's getting there, get to guard basically, and then try and finish it from there. Either triangle, heel, any submission, and then end up getting sub of the night as well. My stand ups came on tremendous since being here, 100%. And my stand ups good, but in the fight, I think it was a little bit nerve-wracking, and because I've never stood up properly in a fight before. But in the gym, I stand up all the time. And I spar with the likes of Terry Etten, Paul Kelly and all that, who's got their stand-up. And I spar with them and get on fine. So my stand-up's good, but I've just never shown it before. I was very confident going into UFC 120 because I fought the best in England and the UK, and I was very confident, and I knew I was going to win by submission. I just didn't know when. I was hoping it was a first round, and it was. I think I'll find out this week when I'm next going to be fighting, and I'm just hoping it's before Christmas, if not March or something like that then, because I want a good Christmas now. Yeah, my last fight was pretty quick. I was hoping to have a bit of a longer fight, but you know, you can't moan. If you knock someone out in 10 seconds, that's all your hard training paying off. It is a little bit frustrating after training for 6 to 8 weeks. I'm always training anyway, but I do train a lot more intense, especially the last 5-6 weeks. So for it to finish that quick, I was a bit frustrated after the fight, but you know, I was happy with the result. I've been trying to get a knockout on, especially on Omar, we've been fighting there for 2 years in front of like 1,200 people who I probably know, 1,100 of them. So, the end, you know, everyone was buzzing after it. You can't moan over a 10-second knockout. I just wish it had gone a little bit longer after training so hard. At the end of the day, it's my first fight in the UFC, so you're not going to get no easy fight in there. Whoever you fight. If, you know, I'll never pick a fight. I'll leave Colin and Joe Silver, whoever's promoting the show, Chris Sauber, I'll fight whoever they tell me to fight. I'll never say I want to fight him. And when you get the UFC, at the end of the day, there's no early fight, no easy fights. You fight who you get matched up with. Whether he's supposed to be one of the top prospects in Europe or he is one of the best fighters in the world, it doesn't matter. I'm still going to train 2-3 times every day as hard as I can, and whoever they give me, I'm going to fight them. I want to fight the best people he is to fight. That's why I train so hard.